This tutorial video introduces the sorting function of the event display. Speaking of event sorting, three different methods are available. The first method is time sorting, which is the most basic setting. You can also sort events based on the number of occurrences and their priority. Let's now explore the project settings. This project contains three events. Each event has different trigger conditions and priorities, including priority levels. For this demonstration, three priority levels, low, normal, and high, were deliberately assigned to the events. Next, let's examine the sorting settings page of the event display object. When sorting by time, you can select the displayed columns and their order. For example, two columns are displayed, trigger time and message. Now, let's explore the sorting by occurrence count settings page. There are two windows for overview and detail settings, where you can select display columns. In the overview window, occurrence count, trigger date, and message are displayed for each event. In the detail window, trigger time, recovered time, and elapsed time are shown for further information. The third sorting method is by priority level. The setting method and display columns are similar to the sorting by occurrence count. The only difference is that occurrence count is replaced with priority level. Now, let's see a demonstration on the HMI. The event display is used to show related information about events. When sorting by time, events are displayed in chronological order. However, with many events, observing and analyzing them can be challenging. Sorting by occurrence count and priority level allows us to focus on the three most relevant events. In the overview window, the same events are grouped together. Clicking on an event provides access to the detail window for more information. Enjoy the freedom to design columns and create customized event display objects. Thank you for watching.